Just a couple of days after I released my full review of Avira's newest free antivirus, they decide to go ahead and do a major UI overhaul and release a new version. Great timing from me. Haha, that's what you get for being disconnected from product launch dates. So this is going to be a really quick follow-up video to that. I'm not going to go through the entire test because, as you will see in a moment, not much has changed in terms of the internal architecture of the product or any of its functionality. The major overhaul in this case being the user interface, which was necessary. But then again, let's take a look at the new UI. Now, this isn't much of an improvement. It's cluttered. I'm okay with that, but it's not okay when it's taking up like 25% or 50% of your view. So we have real-time protection, firewall, other modules, which just redirects us to these pro components that we can buy. And then we have a get pro option on the top. Now here's the thing, I have no issue with them advertising their pro version. I understand fully that they need to do that. But hey, you know, one of these things would have worked instead of having all of these things. And especially the banner at the bottom. This is the real annoyance. But it's still, I guess, an improvement, although not a major one. If we go into settings, we still hop back into the old clunky UI. So hopefully, eventually, they will switch this one as well. If we go into general, we still only have the cloud protection. And even under real time, we don't really have much more. It's just the same stuff in a different package. But just for the heck of it, to see if the alert system has changed or if the product is any more usable now, I will go through a few links. I have VXVault open in another monitor, so let's go ahead and try some of these out. Here's our first malware, ws.exe. Could not be downloaded. Let's wait for the Avira alert. Oh no! No! So they did not change the alert system, and we still have Luke Filewalker walking all over our system. Come on, guys, this is really not an update. I mean, they just changed the face of the program, but the UI is still horrid in terms of the internal UI, and also, I mean, the alerts are still terrible, and the way it deals with threats is still pretty dated. I'm not impressed. I'm not going to even continue with this test. There's no point. It's the exact same thing that I tested a few days ago. So my review still holds. If you haven't watched that video, go ahead and check it out. I'll leave the links over here. I'm going to go back to my breakfast because there's nothing interesting to see here. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. This is Leo. Don't forget to subscribe. And as always, stay informed, stay secure.